South Korea have a double chance to make a final berth tomorrow with two pairs in the semi-finals today. With some incredibly tight and long matches in the women's doubles over the last couple of days, Baek and Lee should be the most fresh, having not dropped a game this week. Our other three pairs went to war deep in the third of their respective quarterfinals yesterday. Will that take its toll? Two court format here on semi-finals day. Court two just being used for a couple of matches, with the other eight being featured here live on court number one. So coming out first, Jeong Na-yoon and Kim Hee-jeong. I think that's to get them out of the way so that the crowd can enjoy this. As we move into the afternoon here inside the Asiata Arena, the crowd starting to fill up in here. The atmosphere the last couple of evenings is almost indescribable. And when the Malaysian players get going, this crowd has provided a real lift. Pearly Tan and her partner Tina Muralitharan have provided so much entertainment already this week. So 1-0 is the head-to-head, with the Koreans taking that match at the All England last year in a third deciding game. That was the quarter-final at the All England last year. A chance to take a look at our two pairs. Pearly Tan is 23 years old now, 5'5" in height from Kedah. In Malaysia, they're ranked number 11 at the moment, but have been up at number 5. That was back in January this year for 3 weeks. This is her partner, Tina Muralitharan. She's 25 years old. Selangor. And oh, how they've delighted the crowd this week. Look at that quarter-final yesterday. 111 minutes. 21-16 in the third against Fukushima and Hirota, who looked to have had it made in the second. What a comeback for the Malaysians. Jeong Na-yoon is 22 years old. She's 5'6", or a touch shorter than that actually, from Seoul in Korea. And her partner, Kim Hee-jeong, the older of the two at 25. She's 5'3" from Masan. They've been up in the top three in the world in the rankings, helped by a couple of impressive wins last year in Korea and Japan. But they've thrown through the mill this week as well. Rahayu and Ramadanti pushed them all the way yesterday. 88 minutes it took to come through in the third in that quarter final. And all of their matches this week have gone the distance. Our umpire for this one is Mai Lenyan from China. And Sydney Galos is back on court from New Zealand as our service judge. So what can this dynamic duo of Tan and Tina do today? Well, the Malaysians in blue with Tina on serve. A sign of things to come. Rally number two in the match. Pearly Tan with a soft block. Just no way to win the rally. Defense of both pairs, so good. Pearly Tan's forehand lets them down finally. Kim able to push forward. Jeong, rather. Serve down the line. Oh, a challenge. Is there a challenge? Yes, a challenge here. In the meantime, Kim Hee-jong removing some strapping from that right ankle. And a good job that Hawkeye is taking his time, allowing Kim to reset. Wonderful challenge. Just wide. Wonderful shot from Tina. Touch a reverse slice to create the angle. Defense from Tina. Well, it's gone wide. Another great rally. Finish. The hard work was done. Tina's smash got the weak reply for Pearly Tan to finish. Good shot from Kim. well played from the Koreans. They're trying to find a way through this Malaysian defence. Pearly Tan's ambitious backhand cross block falls short. Well, we're early into the match. Pearly Tan already showing signs that this week has taken a physical toll on her. Another challenge. The line judge fairly quick to react. And Pearly Tan fairly confident as she watched the lift go long. Just one challenge remains for Jeong and Kim. Ambitious, the return of serve from Pearly Tan.
7-5.
Tan again going for something. Jeong was down for a moment. She's recovered now. And gets back on her feet and finds a winner. Look at this from Jeong Nayun. One moment she's on the floor, the next. It's a great drop shot. Tina Muralitharan there perhaps had dropped a bit too far back in court. superb from Kim. Off the hip in defence one moment. Follows her own block into the net. And I don't think Tina had seen her coming. How about that from Pearly Tan? Jeong Na Yun sent completely the wrong way. Great pickup. Muralitharan working hard in defence. Oh, she's missed. Pearly Tan's the one that it seems is allowed to play with so much freedom. Picking these wild shots out. And she gets them in. She so often finds the clean winner. But when they're not quite there, easy points for the Koreans. 11-6 at the mid-game interval. Well, two quick points back for the Malaysians. And a backhand drive winner for Pearly Tan. Well, there's an example of what I was saying at the mid-game interval. Finds lots of winners, she makes a few errors too. good defence from Tan. Kim and Jeong with the chance to attack. Some excellent defending from both pairs. Tina stretched but survives, and again this time Kim Hee-jung finds the winner. And that will have taken a lot out of the Malaysians. It's not as bad when you win the point to lose a long rally like that. It can deflate you spiritually as well as physically. She's puffing, she's blowing air. After the couple of days they've already had, both pairs really, Pearly Tan and Tina Muralitharan in particular, after that quarterfinal yesterday. A brick wall in defense, the Koreans this time. Oh, it's desperate. Kim's backhand, she was outstretched. Unable to carry the net. More and more seats being filled here inside the Adziata Arena. Tan and Tina using that support from every single voice, every single clap. Will it be enough to carry them through another match? Well, Tina almost knocked back by the shot. Great pickup, first of all, from Tan. Thank you. Tan was hoping for the drop shot. And into the body of Jeong. Well, it's Jeong's own fault, really. That backhand had nothing on it. And wonderful from Pearly Tan. Well, I half expected a challenge here. I think Pearly Tan had good eyes on her own shot. So a little bit of skin damage. Her partner helping repair. See how long that plaster stays on her leg for. Brilliant. Great vision from Pearly Tan. Jeong well back in court in defence. And left a huge space. Plenty of focus on the faces of the Malaysian coaches. Left. Good judgment from Tan. Jeong trying, failing to find a way through. Kim goes over the top. And pays the price for giving away the attack. Off the net, Pearly Tan And Tina, delighted. I love the smiles they've got on their faces, win or lose. They play this sport in such great spirit. Well, this is a massive point. Power from Jeong. Yeah, good rotation. Tina covering for Tan. Tina on the back foot. Pearly Tan trying something special, as she so often does. This time, oh, it's called in. An instant challenge from the Koreans. A Malaysian line judge dare not call a shot like that out in this arena. What a call. The expression says it all. Fair enough. Good shot. Jeong stretched, being picked apart in defence. That was tough. That was, and the finale even better. What a turnaround. And they found another one. It doesn't feel like the Koreans are playing against a women's doubles pair here. The Koreans seem to be playing against 8,000 people inside this arena. Game point for Tan and Tina. Slight confusion, but they've sorted it out, the Malaysians. Good defense. Tina steps forward, she can't finish. Some tired looking legs now. So many of these long rallies already in the opening game. Well, that's incredible. Tina Muralitharan walking now. Jeong with a chance to attack. And still they defend. It might take something special. Pearly Tan now with a chance. Well, this might never end. Kim steps forward. The Malaysians survive again. Well, who wants it most? Oh, it's gone through, Pearly Tan. Kim Nayeon, I think it was, with the cross-drive defense to end an incredible rally. A 186 shot rally. And I would be surprised, but for the few days we've already witnessed this week, both of these pairs in mind.
Service call 90-20.
Well, the Koreans played for around an hour and a half last night in the quarterfinals.
90-20
Tan and Tina from Malaysia played for nearly 2 hours. So you can't blame them for having tired legs here. And they've managed to find a way through at the second time of asking. And the Asiat Arena erupts. The best part is they've got to do it all again at least once. And Rexy Manica, a little celebration dance, if you can call it that. You can't play, Rexy, put that racket down. 21-19, the first. Good shot from Kim. Oh, she's just missed the line. Pearly Tan goes cross smash for the win.
Wow.
Yeah, great setup, and they were queuing up.
subs of 2-4.
Good judgment from Tina Muralitharan. Tan going for the press. The shot was too good from the Koreans. Good judgment from Jeong. There's the aftermath of that dive from earlier. The plaster has come off. Well, it's not bleeding anymore. Just wonder whether another dive without some sort of strapping or plaster might cause some problems. So I think she's looking for some tape now to just cover the wound. That's a good pickup from Tina. It was well played from Kim Hee-jeong, finding space. Tina Muralitharan outstretched, but couldn't keep the shuttle in play.
7-2. Thank you.
Yeah, the channeled attack from the Koreans. As Pearly Tan's pace slows down. It's going to be an uphill battle from this point at 8-2 down for the Malaysian pair in game two. Koreans have gone to three all week long with every match they've played over an hour. Looking somewhat laboured now, the Malaysians at present. I wouldn't be surprised if this second game runs away from them. They need some energy to finish this off. There's not a great deal of point giving their best in game two with such a deficit already. Solid from the Koreans. They're keeping their focus here. They know what they've got to do. Keep the intensity high. Stay out this second game. And both pairs can reset for a third. I think that's what's likely here at 11-2. Well, the Malaysians keeping warm at least. Not really trying desperately to win the rallies at the moment. Just a bit of a stalemate. Kim Hee Jeong, trying to take some initiative. Jeong Na-yun feeling the pain as well. Slightly mistimes the smash.
3-12.
Just to build the context for anybody that hasn't been watching this women's doubles tournament all week long. The Malaysian pair came through a round 16 match against Miura and Sakuramoto in an hour and a half on Thursday. And last night against Hirota and Fukushima of Japan, it took nearly 2 hours, 111 minutes in total, from what was a really heavy losing position at one point. Great net shot from Pearly Tan. There's life in them. Smallest of apology waves with the racket. So getting the net cord. Yeah, in contrast, the Koreans have been through all of their matches this week. Well over an hour. Liu and Tan on day one, 77 minutes. Hirokami and Kato with 69 minutes in the third. And Ramadanti and Apriani Rahayu last night in an hour and a half. So, what I'm trying to say is all four players look exhausted and understandably are exhausted. And we are not talking about five shot rallies in the main. We had one in this match earlier at 186 shots. I think that's our longest to date, today anyway. Yeah, well played. Finding, creating space, finding it with the net shot. Well, maybe there is a way back into the second game for the Malaysians. Well, I thought Pearly Tan was going to take her chance to push forwards, take a break and let her partner Tina do do some running. But she held that mid to rear position. Just gets away with it as Jeong misses the net shot. And Tan loses balance. Well, if the tactic is to wear down your opponents, I think the Malaysians are doing quite a good job here, defending well to the back line, trying to tire out Jeong and Kim for game three, perhaps. Still just 5 points in it, though. There's a chance to get back in this second. Tina really stretched. Jeong can't find a way through. Well, Jeong Na Yun really working hard in this rally. Now perhaps it's Kim's turn. Incredible how long these rallies go when both pairs are trying to win them. Muralitharan has to sit down after finding a winner eventually. Jeong Na Yun, his lift was weak. Tina, with the whole court to go for, walks straight to the seat, sits down. Rexy and his mate, the Malaysian coaches. A muted applause, 151 shots. Nowhere near the longest rally of the match. I think the Malaysian pair are really enjoying this. A well-placed smash from Pearly Tan. Goes across the body of Jeong. Tina with life in those legs. Tan with the cross drive defence sets up the rally. And well executed by Tina. Superb from Pearly Tan. Just brushing across the shuttle, taking all the pace. Jeong Na-yun. Too far back in defence. Just 1 point they trail now. Pearly Tan sprawls on the floor. I thought she got away with it for a moment, the crouch defence. Kim takes the pace off, dragging Tan forward. Well, it's going to take something special for the Koreans to keep ahead here. The Malaysian pair have just won 10 of the last 12 points. Oh, a chance for Kim. Down on her haunches. In frustration that she missed. Really well read. But they can't afford to give the Malaysians points, given how much momentum they've just built up in the last 10 to 15 minutes or so. Indecision from Tina. Well, she had a couple of looks at it. Good length. Good pick up from Pearly Tan. Kim finds a way through straight down the line.
60-20.
Clever attacking play from Kim Ha-jeong. Tina had to cover for Tan very slightly and left more of a space. Kim Ha-jeong working hard. Trying to create that opening. Happy to let the Malaysians have the attack. Tan's gone. She's completely lost out there. And they reset. Go again. Superb from Tan in defence. Nobody wants the attack. It's simply too exhausting at this stage. Not just in the match, but in the tournament after the week they've all had. Are pumping, their legs are burning. And the brain has to take over. Ignore the pain and keep fighting. Wild swing from Jeong on the backhand side. She catches the net. Tan somehow picks the shuttle up. And on it goes. Oh, it's gone wide. And what a reward for all their hard work. BWF technicals taking more water over to the boxes. Still a way to go in the second game here, and we are already at 75 minutes. So many matches played out in this way so far this week. I'm hoping The hosts have got enough water, got enough shuttles to carry us through to the end of tomorrow's finals. Well, if that wasn't an exhausted return of serve, I don't know what is. Halfway up the net. Clash of rackets. I think they're okay.
Serviceable.
70-50. Pearly Tan with the difference when it mattered. Shaped to smash this from the midcourt. Deceptive.
Service ball.
Jeong Na-yeon left stranded. And had a lot of work to do to get back. Still they trail, however. They've been behind since 1-1. Tina can't finish. Great defense. Tina Muralitharan just whipping that shuttle away repeatedly. Oh, just a dive from Tan. Tina survives as well. Kim goes up the line into the empty space. That was the shot from Jeong. The cross block started the whole chain of events. How much is it worth to the Malaysians to take this point? If they lose it 19-16 down, it's going to be a really tough battle back in the second game. To win it, they're back within one. And they've won it. Huge point for the Malaysians' campaign. The whole crowd on the edge of their seats here. Tina now with the chance to attack. And finished by Pearly Tan. They're back level.
Eight more.
What an occasion this is turning out to be. It's incredible from Tina Muralitharan. Under the pressure of these circumstances and this week's history,
19-18.
Let's not forget they were 12-2 down in the game. And now, just 2 points from a place in the final. Great defence from Pearly Tan. And once again, it's Jeong and Kim against, I don't know, 7, 8, 9, 10,000 Malaysians. Still just 2 points from the final for Tan and Tina. It's short from Tina. Jeong's racket's gone, I think. She wants to run off court and get new strings. There she's going, she's gone. What can Kim do? She can survive, that's what she can do. Well, they're playing on pure adrenaline now. What defense from Tan. Muralitharan with a chance to attack. Doesn't last long. Cross smash from Tan. Tina finds a net shot. Jeong Na-yeon can't find any more power. She's just dropping to middle. Keeping it conservative. Who is going to take the risk? Jeong tries half-heartedly. Tina's got the opportunity. She can't find a way through. Kim Hae-jung is perhaps the only one still moving with any intensity. Oh, Tan's missed. Backhand drive into the net. Exhaustion taking over. Look at that from Jeong. Seems to have plenty of time actually to go and get a new racket. And that was a very tired looking shot in the end from Pearly Tan. Well, another monster rally of 160 shots. Add another 20% or so to that to get to where the longest rallies in this match have been. Couple of minutes time will be at an hour and a half, and we're still in the second game. 20-19. Game point for the Koreans. They can't find it. Kim wrong-footed. And late to the shuttle. Tan with something special.
24.
And they're back in touch with the Korean pair. Well, would that line judge dare call that shot in? The call was out. The challenge is for the Koreans. Hawkeye quick. Hawkeye says out. Rexy Manakai in the rear corner for Malaysia, going absolutely crazy in the coaching chair. What a match, what a tournament they've had. Pearly Tan, Tina Muralitharan with match point for a place in the final. And suddenly, everyone's come to life. Looking for a way to finish. Pearly Tan leaves a big space. Jeong Na-yeon finds it. A gamble from Tan. And a very weak backhand. Straight onto the racket of Jeong. He doesn't need much to find that winner. We're into the 92nd minute of this wonderful women's doubles semi-final. Smash. Up another match point. Smash. Sets up another match point. Malaysia. Point, Malaysia.
Incredible from Tan. Jeong manages to keep the rally going.
She's floored, Tina. She gets up and survives. And again, it's a magical moment for Malaysia. What a match. Well, the whole arena is on their feet here. An unbelievable, simply unbelievable performance again this week for Pearly Tan and Tina Muralitharan. What about this defence from Tina? Pure reactions, find space. And somehow has the energy for a tiniest of dances in celebration. Yeah! Congratulations. The whole of Malaysia is with you right now. Straight games, would you believe it? In 93 minutes, Pearly Tan, Tina Muralitharan through to a final at the Malaysia Masters. 21-19, 23-21. And a rapturous applause inside the Atiata as they hobble off court for some well-earned rest. So you join us here in Kuala Lumpur for semi-finals day. At the Malaysia Masters, we're inside the Aziata Arena, who's just witnessed an incredible performance from Pearly Tan and Tina Muralitharan. Women's singles up next. PV Sindhu, the former world champion, she's taking on Gregoria Mariska Tunjung of Indonesia in a couple of moments' time. Well, there's four nations represented.